Ladies and gentlemen, now that the WWE Championship match at WrestleMania has been decided, we must shift our attention to Seth Rollins and the World Heavyweight Championship. After extensive discussions all week, we have collectively agreed that Seth Rollins' challenger at WrestleMania will be determined in Perth, Australia, February 24th, in the Elimination Chamber. And we kick things off tonight with a series of matches to determine the participants in that match. And to reiterate the fact that WWE management is a united front, I will take this opportunity to hand over to my esteemed colleague, the general manager of Raw, Mr. Adam Pearce.
Thank you, Nicholas. Ladies and gentlemen, if I can direct your attention to that Tron and the 12 superstars who will compete for an opportunity to step into the chamber in Perth, the Viper, Randy Orton, Big Bronson Reed, KO, Kevin Owens, the United States Champion Logan Paul, AJ Styles, The Miz, the almighty Bobby Lashley, Ivar, the Scottish Warrior Drew McIntyre, Sami Zayn, representing Judgment Day, Dirty Dom Mysterio. And finally, L.A. Knight. Yeah! Ladies and gentlemen, 12 superstars, 6 matches over 3 events. And it kicks off right now with our first contest pitting AJ Styles against this man, the Scottish Warrior, Drew McIntyre.
This could be a bad move.
Styles out of the way.
That durability of AJ Styles. LA Knight knows all about that after the past few weeks. Calf crusher attempt.
It's in. Styles has it cinched. Calf crusher submission. McIntyre in trouble.
The way his leg is right now, you got to believe this is it, right?
McIntyre scrambling for that rope. Perhaps the only way out of that move. And McIntyre's hopes for an opportunity in the Elimination Chamber live on.
And LA Knight, how are you feeling? We don't even know who your opponent will be in your qualifying match.
Nobody knows. Look, here's the deal. You talk about, again, Elimination Chamber, what is it, 6 guys, 8 guys? I'm not sure how many. Doesn't make a difference. At the end of the day, what you got is I don't know who my opponent
is. Oh,
all
God.
I know is I'm going to end up in that Elimination Chamber when it's all said and done.
Well, right now, things not looking too good for the phenomenal AJ Styles, who was thinking about a phenomenal forearm, but McIntyre again one step ahead, a nasty crash landing, and Styles is all out of sorts.
And this is one thing you're not gonna see at the Elimination Chamber because it can't possibly spill out like this. You're stuck in the thing.
Boom!
Oh boy, all right, we're getting up close and personal now.
That Georgia Bulldog mentality of AJ Styles, just keep fighting, keep moving forward.
Ever since that knee issue.
Oh, look out, guys! AJ Styles just launched in the direction of the megastar. McIntyre wisely rolling back into the ring to break the official's count.
Megastar just poured a bottle of water all over AJ Styles.
What's the matter?
Well, certainly no shortage of history between Styles and Knight. But right now, McIntyre looking to capitalize off of the collision on the outside.
McIntyre will take a win any way he can here. Momentary distraction by LA Knight, but once again, AJ back on top.
Inside cradle, 1, 2, our official Jessica Carr all tied up with LA Knight, who just may have cost Styles the chamber.
Now dropped by AJ Styles. Only a matter of time before the megastar. Ooh! Distraction, time off.
And you can count to 20.
Here is your winner, Drew McIntyre!
What a win for the Scottish Warrior, Drew McIntyre. And had it not been for AJ Styles momentarily taking his eye off the ball, it could be a whole different story, Wade.
See you coming towards me.
If I could have a moment of your time, Drew.
Go on then, Saxton. It's a good week and a good night for old Drew McIntyre.
Indeed. You accomplished the first half of your World Heavyweight title aspirations by qualifying for the Elimination Chamber match per your defeat of AJ Styles. What did tonight's win mean to you?
Everything. This is my way to finally get my moment, to finally get my moment with live fans, to finally get the title for me when my first two reigns were for everybody else, when I was holding down the fort when the world shut down. And I've been doing the right thing, and I know if you keep doing the right thing, you keep working hard, the cream always rises to the top. We got the Cody Rhodes situation I talked about. I injured Punk in the Rumble, sacrificed myself so Cody could finish the story. He messed around for a bit. I had to mess him up a bit till he made the right decision. Seth tried to be selfish and force Cody to go with him, and that's not what the fans wanted. I always want to give the fans what they want. And if I have to take the hard way to the main event of WrestleMania, that's what I'm going to do. If I have to defeat superstars as good as AJ Styles, that's what I'm going to do. If I have to beat everybody in the Elimination Chamber again, which I've done before, I know how to do, that's what I'm going to do. And I'm going to finally get that moment because I don't deserve it. I've earned it. And you know I have.
Well, on that note, you're going to find out later on tonight who else will be joining you inside the chamber as we witness a match between two men who you know very well in Sami Zayn and Randy Orton. Do you plan to stick around to see who wins?
No. But I will give you this shirt, though. It genuinely is flying off the shelf. So here you go. This is your one. Worn by me. It's probably worth a fortune.
It's very sweaty as well. Thank you, Drew.
Situation, but Randy dumped all the way to the outside.
Perhaps just a beat too long for the Viper as he was trying to capitalize on Zayn.
Well, here comes Sami. Oh. Suicide dive, and Orton nearly sent into the front row of the WWE Universe.
Talk about magic and momentum right now, Sami Zayn. This is your big opportunity.
Both of these athletes know exactly what's at stake, a chance to step inside of the most brutal structure. Oh, in WWE, the Elimination Chamber. And Sammy's greatest hopes may have just gone up in smoke.
Well, payback from the Viper. I think they call that one a receipt.
Randy Orton still moving very gingerly by his standards.
So now is Sami Zayn, and that could be pivotal as Randy once again goes for this signature DDT.
Vintage Orton. Thanks, Cole. And right now, Sami Zayn has got to feel the Elimination Chamber slipping through his fingertips.
I don't think he can feel his fingertips at all after that DDT, and it might be academic. Things are about to get poisonous for Sami Zayn.
The Viper coiled, looking for the RKO. Shoulders down, rolled up by Zayn. Orton kicks out.
Just a split second away from stealing the RKO attempt again.
Blue Thunderbomb by Zayn. Cover. Orton survives.
A look at the panic in the eyes of Sami Zayn, who may well have just thrown his best shot at a pre-damaged Viper. And the Viper is back in this.
And that's got to be disheartening if you're Sami Zayn. Delivering the Blue Thunder Bomb, but not enough to put this away. RKO from out of nowhere! The Viper has entered the chamber!
Here is your winner, the Viper, Randy Orton!
The stakes were high tonight, and Sami Zayn gave it all he had. But in the end, the Viper, one of the best to ever do it. Randy Orton overcomes Sami Zayn and punches his ticket to Perth, Australia for the Elimination Chamber.
Bronson Reed has been begging for opportunities. And he's getting one here tonight. Reed, who spent 11 years traversing Australia on the independent circuit before getting a break here in the United States. Big kick by Reed.
I don't think any of us expected him to be able to get his leg up that high.
And now, oh, good night! This may be it! Lashley, off the driver, cover now! Hook of the leg by Reed, and a kick out! Now Bronson believes he may have his chance. Lashley struggling to get back to his feet. One of these men will join McIntyre and Styles in the Men's Elimination Chamber, where the winner earns an opportunity at Seth Rollins in the World Heavyweight Championship at WrestleMania.
Thought Lashley might have baited Bronson Reed there.
Oh, oh, sit down! A spike by Lashley! And Reed able to kick at it, too!
Lexington, Kentucky, easy for me to say, can feel it.
Went for a spear. Jeez. Bronson Reed caught him with a knee in the midsection. Now Bronson Reed gonna slam Lashley.
Oh my God! Oh my God!
And Reed said that's it. Bronson Reed about to punch his ticket to Elimination Chamber.
Bobby Lashley, I'm afraid I've got some bad news for you.
Maybe not. Lashley meets Reed, powers him off the top rope with a massive slam. Spear! The almighty Bobby Lashley qualifies for Elimination Chamber.
Here is your winner, the almighty Bobby Lashley.
Talk about a battle of two titans.
Thanks, guys. I am joined by Bobby Lashley, the Street Profits, and B-Fab. And Bobby, congratulations on your win tonight over Bronson Reed and your Elimination Chamber qualifier. Now, you go on to Perth for the opportunity to compete against Seth Rollins at WrestleMania for his World Heavyweight Championship. Now, Bronson, very disappointed in his loss tonight, but how are you all going to celebrate your win?
I'm excited, but I'm not ready to celebrate right now because I have to win the chamber, and then I have to win at WrestleMania to get that world title back. I've already had it before, and at this point, I've beaten everybody that's in the chamber. So I'm pretty confident right now, but, you know, there's still work to be done, and I'm willing to put it in so that I can get where I want to be.
You know, tonight really was about focused, reclaiming our focus, and that's exactly what Bobby did. When he went in there and took on Bronson Reed and got his spot in the Elimination Chamber.
And don't worry, Bronson, we saw your little tweet. Oh, how I've let my country down. I've always wanted to work a premium live event at home. Well, guess what, buddy? Guess what, pal? I know the moment was too big, but guess what? We got an almighty replacement, Bobby Lashley.
You don't look so good.
Look, the road to gold is all about pride and power. Now, it's time to get back to work. Job not finished. Let's roll. Let's roll. Yeah. Let's roll.
We're going to celebrate a little bit.
Okay. Dinner?
A little bit?
Y'all ready?
Yeah.
Let's go.
I'm hungry.
Right.
Let's go.
Thank you, guys. Well, they head off to celebrate. Let's send it back to you.
A week from Saturday, the winner of that match meets Seth Rollins at WrestleMania for the World Heavyweight Championship. Ivar missed with a spin kick. LA Knight. Oh, and the back gave out. Too much. The 300-pound plus Ivar.
Imagine not being able to get him up there. Any human's back would give out.
Tilt-a-whirl slam. Cover to advance for Ivar and a kick out.
Bingo. Bingo. We don't know exactly what she is.
Oh! Ivar hung up at the top rope. LA Knight back out to the apron.
Wait a minute.
Ivar hooking LA Knight, dragging him into the ring. Up goes Knight and down. Sit out. Powerbomb. Cover off the double underhook and a kick out at two.
Ring intelligence through the roof.
Ivar heading to the corner. LA Knight moves out of harm's way. This could be the opening Knight needs.
Took too long celebrating.
Running knee. Knight trying to build momentum. Now, LA Knight able to deliver the slam. And now the patented elbow drop. Cover. Hook trunk-like leg, but Ivar able to kick out at two.
LA Knight could taste it, could taste the Elimination Chamber. Has to continue to press on.
Weirdo Valhalla biting the ropes as he looks on. LA Knight looking to make it to Perth. Providing a distraction. LA Knight felt it coming, though.
Almost had a Viking on Viking crime.
And Knight went for blunt force trauma. Oh, what a kick by Ivar.
How did he get his leg up that high?
And now, with Knight in trouble, Ivar to the top, looking for the doom salt. LA Knight, though, from behind, BFT, blunt force trauma.
Welcome back to Raw Talk. I am joined by LA Knight, who earlier competed in an Elimination Chamber qualifying match, going on to Perth to compete against five other superstars for the opportunity at Seth Rollins' World Heavyweight Championship at WrestleMania. Now, congratulations, LA, on winning.
No. Save the congratulations. Let me talk to you. There've been a little bit too many congratulations coming my way in the last few months. Let's just be honest. Everybody's been talking about, you know what? LA Knight, he's come out of nothing, and all of a sudden he's this big star. Some would say a megastar, and they'd be right. Huh? Yeah. But here's the thing, man. What do I really have to hang my hat on yet at this point? What do I have to just sink my teeth into yet? And I'd say you got a big fat goose egg. Did I win the Slim Jim Battle Royal? Yeah. Have I become pretty much the biggest star running today? Maybe some would argue there's a couple others up there with me rubbing elbows, but let's just go ahead and call it what it is. You're talking about a man who came from, we'll say, feeble expectations and making it all the way to the top of the damn industry. And people want to give me congratulations for that. No! Save the congratulations. Give me the congratulations when I walk out of Elimination Chamber, the number one contender for that World Heavyweight Championship, and then congratulate me two times when we get to WrestleMania and I take it off of Seth freaking Rollins. Nice middle name you got there, pal, but what you're gonna call yourself after that is former champion, because right now you're looking at the future champion. So you got five other guys walking into Perth, walking into Elimination Chamber, all gonna get dropped. Each one of them get dropped on their head, BFT style, because that's the only way it can go down, and that's not an insult. That is just a fact of life. Why is that? Because whose game is it? What everybody's saying, you know they know, everybody knows, L.A. Knight. Yeah.
New champ coming through.
What a declaration that was. I'm going to send it back to you in the studio.
This is disrespect of the highest order to Dirty Dom.
Well, what a slap in the face to the modern-day Latino Heat.
Countering the three amigos with three friendly Canadians. Nothing friendly about the DDT from Dom. Hooks the leg. Is Dominic going to the Elimination Chamber? No. This is Friday Night SmackDown on Fox. We are sold out in Salt Lake City, Utah, from the Delta Center, the home of NBA's Utah Jazz. And Dominic Mysterio looking to deliver like the mailman, but nobody home. Owens out of the way.
KO with just about enough in the tank. Both men running on fumes at this point. It really is up for grabs, and this could be the piece de resistance.
Swanton connects. Covered by Owens. And Dominic kicks out again.
How can you not love Dirty Dom Mysterio?
Dirty Dom may not be your favorite, but you got to respect him. Owens looking for the stunner. Oh. Mysterio with a kick. Now Dom's going to dial it up. 619.
The most perfectly executed 619 ever.
And Owens keeps this one alive.
Well, that would have been poetic had Dominic won with that match after KO.
Go get me a chair. Go get me a chair. You want to be part of Judgment Day? Give me a chair.
You said I wouldn't eat Judgment Day.
You are.
Yes, I'm
You're a Judgment Day. Give me a chair.
Give me a
chair.
True or not, Dominic just ordered R-Truth to grab a steel chair after telling Truth that he is in fact part of Judgment Day.
Time to earn your stripes, R-Truth. Every member of Judgment Day must do his duty. No.
I don't think that's what Dom had in mind.
Worst plan execution ever.
Super kick by KO.
Do it, Dom.
Pop a powerbomb. Chamber.
Here is your winner, Kevin Owens.
Drew, another superstar has just been added to the Elimination Chamber match. Kevin Owens.
I do not care if it's an Elimination Chamber match. It's going to be the top superstars in WWE, and of course they all want to win, but there's only one superstar that needs to win. Not just for myself, for Raw, for the world title, for the people, the savior of WrestleMania, Drew McIntyre. Now, 4 years ago, my moment was stolen from me, and what?
I need this, I need that, whatever. Let me talk to you. Look, here's the thing, man. You're talking about all of this, and look, you talk about your moment being stolen. Your moment can get stolen one more time at Elimination Chamber, courtesy of the man they call the megastar with everybody saying, L.A. Knight. Yeah.
You're good.
Oh, thank you.
But all this bravado, this over-the-top personality, I see through you. This all comes from a place of insecurity, and you should be insecure as much as they're behind you now, as entertaining as you are now. When that bell rings, that's where you're going to lose them.
Oh, tell me about it.
Produce results. You don't produce titles, they'll turn on you. Produce zero. Look at my resume. Stacked.
Oh, man, I'm glad you brought up that resume. As a matter of fact, thanks for the advice, old-timer. Here's the thing. When I look at your resume, you talk about being champion. You ain't been champion since I've been here of anything. Matter of fact, you talk about losing to people. That's exactly what you've done over the last 2 years. But I tell you what, when I look at this, I just think to myself, well, it's a cute little shirt you got here, but there's enough room on that tombstone for one more name. I see CM Punk. I can see DM Punk going right there. Your aspirations buried just the same.
There you go, right back to the jokes.
No, there ain't no jokes. I'm being dead serious.
Are you
right
serious?
Now. Yeah, no, no, we're talking serious about the Elimination Chamber. No, we're just talking. We're just talking serious, right? We're talking serious. Are we
serious?
Oh, yeah. Where are you going? We're just talking.
I am standing by with the United States champion, Logan Paul. And Logan, tonight is your first match on SmackDown. So,
yeah, that's absolutely right, Byron. First ever live television match, and I want to say you're welcome. To you, to the entire WWE universe, you guys are welcome. So why don't you go on your little phones, log on to X, whatever it is you peons do, get a little hashtag thank you Logan going, because tonight they're gonna get to see me knock out The Miz live on SmackDown. I'm the only champion in the qualifying matches, Byron. And so I'm gonna win my qualifying match tonight. I'm going to Australia. I'm gonna win the Elimination Chamber. And then mark my words, I will rematch Seth Rollins at WrestleMania and become the World Heavyweight Champion. You know what that makes me? WWE's double champ. Logan Paul, double champ. I like the way that sounds.
Well, Logan Paul is set to go one-on-one with The Miz in a Elimination Chamber qualifying matchup next, right here on Friday Night SmackDown.
Now the bullseye is set.
When you're this deep into a matchup, Wade, and you've got something essential like a leg, a limb taken away from you, how hard is it to call an audible mid-match if you're Logan Paul?
Well, as much as anything else, it is mentally destroying, taking away someone's will. When you're already screaming in agony, but
wow!
What a second.
The official was tied up at the ring apron. Logan Paul went to the eyes.
Oh.
Paul crushing finale. Oh, my goodness.
Well, how bad would that have been for The Miz to have lost to his own signature move that he probably taught Logan Paul once upon a time?
I don't think there's any probably about it. Logan, with the disrespect, nearly ended this.
What else have you got in the tank, Logan Paul, or was that your best shot?
And again, you see the 2K24 ratings in the bottom of your screen. This is reality, and Logan was about to punch his ticket to the chamber.
If Miz wins this match, they might have to flip those ratings.
Sunset flip rolled through by the Miz, looking for the figure four leg lock. This could spell catastrophe for the United States champion.
This is absolute agony. I lost to the Miz at WrestleMania to this exact hole.
Logan frantically moving himself toward the bottom rope. This is going to force the official to break the hold.
I wish I thought of that at WrestleMania.
But has the damage been done?
Logan staggered on the outside. Miz looking to go in for the kill, but perhaps once again, Logan simply baiting in the A-lister.
Oh, no. It's Logan's buddy, Jeff, again.
When in doubt, go for Old Faithful and those brass nuts.
But Miz putting a stop to whatever Logan was looking to do with the brass knuckles. Referee Dan Angler saw that the Miz was considering utilizing the brass knuckles, and Miz refusing to fall victim to the same tactics that stopped KO at the Royal Rumble.
Yeah, those knucks are bait. Be very careful. Miz is too small.
A left to the chin of the champion.
Oh, but talk about small. What a nice move from Kevin.
Night.
I'm going to Australia.
Driving Miz down, hooking both legs. The Maverick is going to the Elimination Chamber.
Here is your winner, the United States Champion, Logan Paul!
This may very well be the biggest chamber event, the best, biggest chamber match we've ever had as well. It's in Perth. It's going to be in front of thousands and thousands and thousands of people that have been waiting for a PLE in their city, in their country, on their continent for a very long time. It really does not get much bigger than this. You know, WrestleMania is huge, but Elimination Chamber is gonna give WrestleMania a run for its money as far as the sheer magnitude of the event and what it means to everybody. Chamber, bring it on. As risky as it is, as dangerous as it is, I'm all in. I'm gonna give everything I have. I'm gonna leave it all in. Leave it all in Perth.
Hey, Miz, I beat you 2 times. That was too easy. I'm too good. I'm going to Australia. I'm going to win the Elimination Chamber. I'm going to beat Seth Rollins at WrestleMania, and I'm going to have 2 titles.